Welcome back to Hibbern 00, part 2 for putting LEDs on your layout. Designed a little base for the bottom of the lamp using my filament printer. Simple little design, done in Fusion 360 I use now for doing my designs rather than Tinkercad. The idea being is paint it up and you will eventually knock over the LED on the lights being as tall as this when you're working on your layout. So it's an easy repair rather than have the pole stuck into the board. What happens, I super glue this part on here and you did knock it, it just knocks down like that. It's just a simple super glue back in again. So print them off the printer and then a little coat of paint, a bit of Cemento from Valio paints and a bit of black from Valio paints as well. The important thing is, because it's done on the filament printer, you need to seal it first before you paint it, and I use Halfords grey primer. Needless to say, Halfords don't sponsor this channel, it's still the wife. So the other thing I do in the build as well is I make up this little bus bar. It's got two wires. The red wire goes to my DCC accessory decoder, and the black wire is a common 0 volts. It goes into any the 0 volts on the layout. I've got two buses. I've got a 5 volt bus and I've got a 12 volt bus, and the 0 volts on both of the buses are linked. So it doesn't matter if it goes into a 12 volt bus or a 5 volt bus. It's still going to give me the 0 volts. For the bus, I just use a bit of Vera board and a double header pin. Stick it in there, solder them across, and you get your wires in there as well. I do drill a 3mm hole and I use a little white spacer as well. That gives me room for the screw to go into the board, and also, yeah, miss out the little bits of solder as well. So basically it goes in that way there. I also mark with a Sharpie the 0 volt side just so you can reference it. It is red. I haven't found a PCB header yet where you can buy it one side red, one side black. If you have seen them before, leave a comment. I've got a little mix of accessory decoders here, and it's quite important to set your accessory decoder right for the LEDs. It's going to be set to a steady state. Some only put out a pulse to move the little solenoids to move points, and they're not good for your DCC control for the LEDs. So some you can go into the CV values, some you can go into the hardware to change them. For me, I use the DCC NEX controllers and I set it using the computer using Mardec. And the good thing about the DCC controller is pin 1, 2, 3 and 9, you can do pulse width modulation. So basically, if the light's too bright, you can dim it down. When you start the light up, rather than being on right away, you can also put it on gradually so it becomes brighter. And the same again, you switch it back off again, rather than being right off the LED, you can have the effect that it cools the filament down so it dims before it switches itself off. So I've drilled a 3mm hole in the baseboard where I want the LED to go through, and I put them through one at a time. The hole wasn't quite big enough because you're using a base as well. You can actually put a bigger hole, 3mm. I say just to attach it. So blobby super glue. Put the LED where you want it. Just got a good kick, my kicker. That's it. So if you do knock it off, it's only little glue job to reinstall the LED. So we'll go underneath the layout now and we'll wire in the bus to the LEDs and also to the DCC controller. That's the LED lights wired into the bus. I'll take this to the common, I'll take this to the decoder. So I'll plug the ground into the 5 volt bus. I'll plug down the board. So I'll just route the cable down to the DCC next. I've got pin 3 available, it's on a dew point connector as well, so I'll cut that to size and put it in. So that's the wiring done. I'll plug in the computer to the DCC next, program the pulse width for modulation, and I also need to go up and program the ECOS as well for the LED lights. Well, that's as good. I've all wired in. The DCC's been programmed into the ECOS, the MARDEX's been programmed into the DCC next, so I'll switch them on. They're all right. I'll put them back off. They go off at a slower speed. So I'll let you see it with the lights off as well. Hope you've enjoyed it, folks. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Goodbye.